So hello friends, today we are going to see electrical drives. Now let us see what is meant by electrical drives. Systems employed for motion controls are called as drives. It may employ any of the prime movers such as diesel or petrol engines, gas or steam turbines, then steam engines, hydraulic motors and electric motors for supplying mechanical energy for motion control. Drives employing electric motors are called as electrical drives. So parts of electrical drives, or you can say block diagram for electrical drives. So you can see here a source of electrical supply connected to power modular, which is connected to motor, and motor is connected to load. So in between motor and load, you can see there is a sensing unit which gives signal to control unit. Control unit get another signal as input command, and output of control unit is supplied to power modulator. So now let us see one by one functions of each component of electrical drives. So let us start with power modulator. Power modulator regulates the output of power of the source. So it draws the power from the source as per the requirement. It controls the power from the source to the motor in such a manner that motor transmits the speed torque characteristics required by the load. During the transient operations like starting, braking and speed reversing, the excessive current is drawn from the source. So for these operations, excessive current is required, and that is drawn, excessive current is drawn from the source. This excessive current drawn from the source may overload it, and it may cause a voltage drop. Hence, the power modulator restricts the source and motor current. So that is the functionality of power modulator. The power modulator converts the energy according to the requirement of the motor. For example, if the source is DC and the induction motor is used, then power modulator converts DC into AC. So our induction motor is of AC and the source is DC. So power modulator converts DC into AC. It also selects the mode of operation of motor, that is motoring or braking. So it is used to select the mode of operation of motor. Next is control unit. So you can see in the block diagram, control unit, which has input of sensing unit and another input of input command. And control unit gives input to the power modulator. The control unit controls the power modulator, which operates at small voltage and power levels. The control unit also operates the power modulator as desired. It also generates the commands for the protection of power modulator and motor. An input command signal which adjusts the operating point of the drive from an input to the control unit. Next one is sensing unit. So in the block diagram you can see here, So this is the sensing unit which gets signal from motor and load and which gives input to control unit. Sensing unit, so it senses the certain drive parameter like motor, current and speed. It mainly required either for protection or for closed loop operation. So basically sensing unit is used for closed loop operation or for protection of the overall system. Advantages of electric drives. The electrical drives are available in a wide range of torque, speed and power. So there is a wide variety of electrical drives available in the market as per our requirement. So they are adaptable to almost any operating conditions such as explosive, then radioactive environment, then submerged in liquids, vertical mounting and so on. So in all these types of working environment, working conditions, electrical drives can be employed. The electrical drive does not pollute the environment. That is the biggest advantage. It can operate in all four quadrants of speed torque plane. They can be started instantly and can immediately be fully loaded. That is, there is no need to refuel or warm up the motor. Instantly they can be started. They have flexible control characteristics and can be employed to automatically control the drive. Because of these advantages, the mechanical energy already available from a non-electric prime mover is sometimes first converted into electrical energy by a generator and back to mechanical energy of an electrical motor. So that is also available, that is also possible. Electric link thus provides between the non-electrical prime mover and the load impact to the drive flexible controls characteristics. So electrical link is also, or electrical link can be also provided here. Disadvantage of electrical drives. The power failure completely disables the whole system. So if at all there is a power failure, then complete system collapsed. The application of the drive is limited because it cannot be used in a place where the power supply is not available. Obviously, if at all there is no power supply available at the site, the system will not work. It can cause noise pollution. And the initial cost of the system is high. So these are the various disadvantages of electric drives. Then classification of electrical drives. So there are three categories. First is group drive, then second is individual drive, third is multi-motor drive. So let us see one by one. First is group drive. If several groups of mechanism or machines are organized on one shaft and driven or actuated by one motor, the system is called as group drive or shaft drive. So in this group drive, there is a group of mechanism or machine that can be run by using one shaft, or for that only one shaft rotational motion is given, or only one motor is used. So that is called as group drive or shaft drive. Advantages of group drive. It is most economical. Disadvantages. Any fault that occurs in the driving motor renders all the driving equipment idle. See, if at all there is a problem with driving motor, and since there is only one driving motor, so overall system will fail or it won't work. efficiency is low because losses occurring in the energy transmission mechanism, that is power loss, is there. So that's why efficiency is low. Not safe to operate. Also, noise level at the working spot is high. Then individual drive. If a single motor is used to drive or actuate a given mechanism and it does all the jobs connected with this load, the drive is called as individual drive. For example, lathe. All the operation connected with operating lathe may be performed by using a single motor. So disadvantage, power loss occurs. And finally, third category, multi-motor drive. Each operation of the mechanism is taken care of by a separate drive motor. Separate motors are provided for actuating different parts of the driven mechanism. The system contains several individual drives, each of which is used to operate its own mechanism. So for every mechanism, for every machine, there will be a separate motor. Advantage: each machine is driven by a separated motor and it can be run and stopped as desired. Machines not required can be shut down and also replaced with a minimum number of dislocation. There is flexibility in the installation of different machines. In case of motor fault, only its connected machine will stop, whereas others will continue working undisturbed. So since there are single machine for single motor for a single machine, so for every machine there is an individual motor, hence the working is undisturbed. Absence of belts and line shafts greatly reduces the risk of accidents to the operating personnel. Disadvantage: initial cost is high since there are number of motors are employed for number of machines. Then selection of motor for a particular application. So there are number of parameters are there, like economical operation, then dependable, then efficient. Efficiency ranges from 65% to 95%. Then long life, around 20 to 30 years of proper application, proper life with proper care, ease of operation, special skills not required, safe. Then low service requirement, then quiet operation, automation, adaptable, light, compact, easily moved, and available. So due to standard parts employed, it is available throughout the country. Since standard sizes, wiring equipments are used. So these are the various parameters for selection of motor. Okay. Thank you.